And so he asked me to do the program today, so I said, sure. A lot of people ask me about the organization, as in the Korean Women's Association. And so I said, sure, this will give me an opportunity to tell people what we do. He says it's empty. Oh, this PC. Almost there. So 5 months ago this week, I took over as the executive director of the Korean Women's Association. And this is my first formal presentation. So I'm about maybe one or two steps ahead of the rest of you in explaining what it is we do. We incorporated as a 501c3 in 1972 when the Korean Women's Association applied for their first government grant before they had survived just on donations from individuals. It was founded by Korean immigrants who were married to American service members. And they started as a social club, but they quickly learned that what they really enjoyed was helping other immigrants socialize and avoid isolation once they came to the United States. Not just those who came from Korea, but from everywhere in the Pacific. And what they realized was that they enjoyed filling community needs. So the issues that they began addressing out of need included citizenship applications and preparation for new immigrants, English as a second language, housing for aging immigrants who couldn't afford the market rate housing, in-home care for aging immigrants to allow them to stay in their homes longer rather than having to move to some form of nursing facility, domestic violence assistance, which continues to be an issue in the armed services, health and wellness, including behavioral health, and hot meals and nutrition education for immigrants and seniors. Today, the annual budget is $36 million. The majority of that is in in-home care through a contract with the Department of Social and Health Services. All other programs rely on grant funding and donor funding. We have 1,200 employees in Western Washington, in 11 Western Washington counties, from Chehalis to Clallam. I think that's the one Squibb is in. And we currently serve all populations, not just Koreans or not just Asians, but even back in 1972 when they accepted their first government grant, they were a little shocked when they found out if you take government money, you can't decide to serve certain populations and ignore others. So even though the name has stuck as Korean Women's Association because of its founders, they continue to serve all populations, or we continue to serve all populations. The service areas that we have today include 200 units of affordable and senior housing. We have a project in Federal Way called Senior City that has 65 units of housing. We have the Olympus Hotel downtown, which is above what used to be Patty Coins. It's now the Forum. And we own that entire building, so the restaurant is our tenant there. We have 55 units called International Place, which is in Salishan, which is owned by, or the rest of the property is owned and operated by the Tacoma Housing Authority. And we have 25 units at our main headquarters on East 96th. We are one of the largest in-home care providers in the state of Washington. The other ones are ResCare, Catholic Community Services. We have a domestic violence shelter in a confidential location in Tacoma, and that was one of the first projects that the founders put together. We continue to have immigration and naturalization classes. We serve mostly Asian Pacific Islanders, anyone who speaks Spanish, and anyone who speaks Russian. And Tacoma Community House pretty much does the African continent and the Middle East. But we provide a very similar service to those different populations. We own an apple orchard down in Roy with 6 single-family homes on it. That may seem like a really odd thing to have, but apparently when the property was purchased, the plan was to develop all of it into housing, and then we learned that it was on lands that couldn't be developed. But it could be, we could plant apple trees, so we did. We're in partnership with the Emergency Food Network. We harvest those apples in partnership with Harvest Pierce County, and then all of those apples go to EFN and they're donated throughout the county. We are also working with them to develop vegetable gardens that will allow us to provide fresh vegetables to our domestic violence shelter and to our hot meal sites. We operate a breast cancer screening and navigation program for non-English speaking people through the Carol Milgard Foundation, the Carol Milgard Breast Center, and the partners there are MultiCare Franciscans and the Susan G. Komen Foundation. We have a small mental health and chemical dependency program, but that will be growing. We're in, we just received a grant from the MultiCare Foundation to develop a subcontract under MultiCare to provide culturally and linguistically competent mental health and chemical dependency services. And then we have three hot meal sites where we provide meals to over 100 people at six different times throughout the week. We have several development projects that are underway. An aging-in-place campus in Tacoma, which will have 75 units of senior housing, 75 units of assisted living, 60 nursing rehabilitation beds, a wellness aquatic center, and a community hall. It'll be all on one campus, the goal being to age in place so you don't have to move and any additional care, that those services will be brought to you in your home. Are any of you familiar with the Lutheran retirement community? It's very similar to that, as the same types of services all on one campus. We're also in conversation with a for-profit developer in Bremerton who's currently our landlord for our office there, and they have asked us to develop 100 to 125 units of senior affordable housing in Bremerton. And that project has just started, and we have a developer on our side. They have a for-profit developer, so it will have two towers of apartments with an urgent care and some commercial space all on the same campus. And that'll be actually a view of the water there in Bremerton. And then the other big thing we have coming up is our 45th anniversary celebration on October 14th. And I will make sure everyone knows exactly the details of that event so that you all can attend that. And then I wanted to provide an opportunity for people to ask questions about what we do or how we do it.
Funding, tell us about how your funding is.
Well, we have a fee-for-service contract with DSHS for our in-home care, and that's the majority of our funding. And so we're paid per hour for every hour that we send someone into someone's home. And that funds more than 80% of our total budget. Then we have grants at the federal, state, county, and city level for all of our other programs. We also have private donors and corporate donors. And every 5 years we hold an event. We just hired our first director of development and our first communications manager. So it's likely we'll be having an annual event soon, but for now it's been every 5 years. And so we raise some money that way as well. The grants generally are not funded as well as the fee for service. The fee for service, the way it works, once you earn it, you are able to use those funds to do other things within your organization that help the community. On grant funds, it's usually very restricted funding, and they say how much you can spend on admin, how much you can spend on telephones, on mileage, etc. And you have to negotiate all of that in advance. And that's what most nonprofits are surviving off grants alone, which is why they need a lot more fundraising than KWA has needed in the past. Stephen and then Brett.
Two questions. The 125 senior housing unit, where would that be? And then number two, on North 9th, What office is that?
I'm not aware of a North Nine.
Oh, so by the Kleiner Center, that's not a, you don't have a.
Here in Tacoma?
Yeah, nothing there. Okay, there we go.
The 100 to 125 units is in Bremerton. And it's where, I don't know the geography well enough to say exactly, but I know you can see two bridges from it over the water.
So is that a different one than the one that you, like two slides before that?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, so we're looking at two major projects, one in Tacoma, one in Bremerton. And the one in Tacoma, we have a lead on a couple of sites. Tacoma Housing Authority would be the developer for us on that project. And because it's just leads so far, we don't have a definite answer on the site yet. And Greg?
Yeah, I had no idea KWA was that big. I mean, 36 million annual budget, was that right?
Yeah, yes, most people don't.
That's amazing. Yeah, I mean, it seems like it's one of the best kept nonprofit secrets in Tacoma in terms of its size. Yeah, I mean, occasionally hear about it, but not much. Is there anything that you have plans to do or will be doing to really get the word out more about your services?
Well, this is the first week that our communications manager has been on board. Our development director has been on for about 6 weeks. So we're working on plans to raise our profile. Sally was next.
Trey, are you responsible for everything that we saw here? I mean, are you responsible for all of Washington?
I am. That's why I look so tired. You thought it was just age.
Is there a chance you might be changing the name of the organization? I mean,
so the previous executive director, Peter Ansara, who's now at the county, he's the director of community connections. I met with him right after I received the offer, and the first thing he said was, "Whatever you do, don't try to change the name." The board is still all women, 15 Korean American women, one Chinese American, and one Anglo American. So they still have a tight identity to the name. Now, Pete did a good job of rebranding as KWA so that it at least leads with an acronym instead. There's not another three words that it stands for. Like several organizations had changed their names a few years ago where they kept the same acronym but chose different words. We've not done that, and I don't think there's an intention to, but I know that there's a lot about the Korean culture that plays into the caregiving that occurs in the services we provide, and so they feel very strongly about keeping that name.
Do you have a slogan or a motto for the organization?
Yes, that I should have memorized by now. I know it has.
What's your four words?
It has the words care, multilingual, and multicultural in it.
That's good enough. Ken. Sounds like you've mentioned that Tacoma Community House sort of has one focus, but very similar in their goals. Do you guys partner with them, or do you have any synergies with trying to make sure you have a holistic overlap versus fighting over the same?
We do over the immigration and naturalization services, that's the main thing they do, and they have a larger program for that than we do. In fact, I have a meeting scheduled today with Liz Dunbar to talk about our collective reaction to the executive order that came out about immigration and travel. Rick?
There are several traditional not friends in that part of the world. Japanese and Koreans come to mind, Chinese and Taiwan come to mind. Do you run into problems working with those kind of ethnic minorities with your Korean birth?
Well, less here than you would expect, but there are some. There are various groups that have inaccurate stereotypes about other groups, and we do deal with that. Not as much as in other parts of the world, but we do see that, and we do have conversations about it at the leadership level and training about it to all of our staff.
Virginia? What is the size of your staff, permanent and the part-timers or the caregivers?
1,200.
Wow, okay.
And the vast majority of those, about 1,000, are in-home care providers.
You serve both men and women, not just women?
Yes.
Yeah.
We do.
Tell us about your long-range plans.
Well, the long-range plans are to continue to develop more senior housing and more housing that is friendly to people who aren't, you know, the white Anglo-Saxon Protestants. And that's part of, and we historically, I don't know if any of you know Lua Pritchard, but she was the executive director before Pete was. And she did the development of all of the existing housing that we have. When Pete took over, the recession hit, the housing trust fund plummeted, and it was very difficult to develop non-affordable, non-profit housing. And now that the economy's recovered, our plans are to catch up with that again. Karen.
So now that you've been there 5 years, did you say?
Yes.
What was your biggest aha or surprise as you got into learning more?
I had an immediate response, but I'm not sure that's the one I was. I found out I like all Korean food. I knew I liked some, but I actually like all of it. My nickname now is Kimchi Man. And several of the members of the board have said that I'm 95% Korean because of how much I eat.